On today's episode, the Boeing saga drags on and what no one will tell you about manufacturing quality. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. For the news media, that door plug blowout on the Alaska Airlines 737 is the gift that keeps on giving. The most recent iteration of this slow-motion train wreck was reported on CNN, where a former Boeing employee specified a non-737 MAX for a recent flight, and when seated on one, walked off the airplane and waited hours to be rebooked on a different airframe. Now, when the man or woman on the street does this, we may roll our eyes, but when someone who purportedly knows how things work at Boeing does it, it's national news. And that's fair enough, but there are some very important things everyone needs to know about inspection and quality control in manufacturing processes, and they apply to every industry, whether you're baking cookies or making rockets. The first issue is that so-called 100% inspection isn't really 100%. In the automotive industry, I've worked with statistical quality control, and even when we assigned an inspector to examine every part coming off the line, we still saw as many as 5 points of non-compliance for even a relatively simple attribute. Human hands, eyeballs, and minds are notoriously unreliable, and it isn't because of carelessness either. People are excellent at convincing themselves that what we think we see is reality. Now, I've seen inspectors subconsciously move their fingers off the ratchet of a micrometer to add just a little force to get a desired dimension. It happens everywhere. The second issue is that human factors are very much at play where humans inspect things. Everyone in large production environments are worried about things like alcoholism, drug use, mental illness, and physical disability. The dirty secret here is that workers, good and bad, are incredibly good at hiding things that may compromise their performance. It isn't the heroin addict in deep withdrawal holding you up with a revolver that you worry about, and don't ask me how I know about that. It's the high-functioning alcoholic or narcotics user who holds it together well enough that they function seamlessly in their work environment. And the high-functioning types are extremely good at working around drug testing regimes as well. And you can't tell looking at them or talking to them. The third issue are human factors not related to things like substance abuse. An inspector with chronic low back pain that is legally and reasonably medicated may not be razor sharp in an inspection task. The same is true of a chronic insomniac who is fatigued on the job, or the hard partying character who gets through the day on coffee, cigarettes, and Red Bull. Psychiatric factors are at play here too. Someone who's chronically depressed may function completely normally in almost any task, 9 to 5, but they may be compromised for some specific inspection roles. Now, I'm not saying that manufacturing is rife with compromised or incompetent quality inspectors. I'm just saying that quality inspection is not a go, no-go gauge. Quality itself has variable quality, and automating inspection systems can help, but can also inject new sources of error into the inspection process. So how do those bolts on the Boeing 737 door plug get missed? Well, it's important, but it shouldn't surprise anyone who works in manufacturing. But a reality check is important too. All those factors I mentioned about quality control inspectors, well, they apply to airline pilots as well. Now, I'll be flying on a 737 soon, and I know statistically that the personal habits of the Uber driver that gets me to the airport are bigger determinants of personal safety than the actions of some line worker at Boeing or Spirit Aerosystems. Now, this doesn't excuse Boeing, but there's an old saying about not wanting to know how sausages are made. Well, that old adage applies to a lot more than sausages. Well, that's it for today's episode of End of the Line, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, Designing the Future, and the Engineering Roundtable, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.